Alright, so now starting with the next pattern or next video of this chapter, which is 5.2 introduction. In 5.2, before I start 5.2, just recalling the formula which we have learned in the previous exercise. General term, if you want to find AP, general formula will be A plus D, A plus 2D. This is the formula to make AP. If A and D is given with the help of this formula, you can make AP. Okay. So now, with the help of this, we have a formula which is AN formula is A plus N minus 1D. AN equal to A plus N minus 1D. By this only we are making the formula, because as you observe, first term is A1, second term is A2. So if you observe, if you want the second term, if I in place of N, if I am putting 2, if in place of N I am putting 2, A2 will be A plus 2 minus 1D. So A2 is A plus D. Check, if I put N as 2, A2 will be A plus 2 minus 1D. So A2 will be A plus D. Check, first term is A1. Second term is A plus D. Second term is A plus D. Similarly, if you check with 3, if in place of N I will write 3, 3 is equal to A plus 3 minus 1D. So I will get A3 as A plus 2D. So this is the third term. Right? This is first term, this is second term, this is third term. So using this only, the general formula is AN is A plus N minus 1D. This formula is very, very important. This will be used in solving sums, because this is the formula, but we have a general with the help of this. This is the formula. Now let us understand each properly. AN is equal to A plus N minus 1D. D is what? D is known as difference. What is the difference in AP? Okay. N is number of terms. How many terms are there in AP? If it is 2, 4, 6, 8, there are 4 terms, 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 terms. N means number of terms. A means first term. What is first term in this? 2 is the first term. A means first term. AN means last term, or which term is asked accordingly. It can be taken as last term also, or it can be taken that which term is asked. Okay, AN is last term, A is first term, N is number of term, D is the difference. So using this four unknown variables, we will be solving the next exercise. If you know this properly, easily you can do. Only this formula you should know, and understanding of the formula. So let us move with the question of exercise, which is this 5.2. Now using the formula is, if I check the first question, A is given, D is given, N is given, AN is given. Formula is what? AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 D. Now using this formula, in this four variables, 1, 2, 3 and 4, from this four variable, one is unknown. Can you easily find the answer of AN? A is given, D is given, N is given. AN you have to find, AN is asked. First question is this, A is 7, D is 3, N is 8 and AN is question mark. So AN we can find, AN will be, A is what? 7 plus, N is 8 minus 1 and D is 3. So if I solve, AN is equal to 7 plus, first solve bracket, 8 minus 1, 7 into 3. So AN is equal to, first multiply, bold mask rule, 7 plus 21. So AN is equal to 28. Simple, very simple question. If you know the formula directly, second question similarly you have, AN is equal to A plus N minus 1D. Again here what is given? A is given minus 18, D is not given, D is question mark, N is 10 and AN is 0. So whenever you are doing these questions, always first write what you have, what is the given in question. A is given, D is not given, N is given 10 and AN is given 0. Substituting the value in this and you can find D. A is what? Minus 18, AN is 0. So AN will be 0 equal to A is minus 18, plus n minus 1. So 10 minus 1 and d is unknown. So if I shift it over there, 18 is equal to 10 minus 1, 9d. So 18 upon 9 is equal to d. So 2 will be d. Difference will be 2. Easy. Similarly, third question is there, where a is asked. So using the same logic, we can find this. Okay. So if I discuss that third question, in third question a is not given, a is asked, d is minus 3, n is 18, and an equal to minus 5. So using this, check the third question. It is a is not given, d is minus 3, n is 18, and an is minus 5. While seeing the video, I prefer that you keep that PDF with you, so it is easy to understand. Now I have just written from the question itself, a is unknown, d is minus 3, n is 18, and an is equal to minus 5. Check third question. A is unknown, d, all these values are given. Simply putting the formula is an is equal to a plus n minus 1 d. So an is what? Minus 5 is equal to a unknown plus n minus 1. 18 minus 1, d is minus 3. So minus 5 is equal to a plus 17 into minus 3. So minus 5 is equal to a plus minus minus. So 17, 3 is a 51. So if you will shift there to make a as subject, minus 5 plus 51 is equal to a. So how much? 46. A is 46. So I believe you understood. Remaining fourth and fifth question, try on your own. Very simple questions, same formula will be used, so solve it. Now moving with the next question, which is, choose the correct choice in the following and justify. Now again, it is the same type question, but it is given in a MCQ type. Now let us read the question. 38th term of the AP 10-7-4- is what? Now what will be the 38th term? This is first term, this is second term, this is third term. So what will be the 38th term? First term is 10, second term is 7, third term is 4. So what about the 38th term? So let us write what you, with the help of question, what you are getting. You can say A is what? A will be 10, first term is 10. T will be what? A2 minus A1. We have learned in the previous exercise, A2 minus A1. D will be 7 minus 10. You can always A2 minus A1, or you can do A3 minus A2. Anything you can do, you can say same answer. D is what? Minus 3. D is minus 3. So A you have and D you have. Now what they have asked, what is 38th term? It means A30 is question mark. What is A30? So what is the formula again? An is equal to A plus N minus 1 D. 30 means N will be 30. N is equal to 30. With the help of this 38 term, it means, you know, number of term means 30 is there. So in place of A, and you will write A30 is equal to A is 10 plus N minus 1. N is what? 30. 30 minus 1 and D is minus 3. So if you solve this, 10 plus 29 into minus 3. So 29 3 is how much? 29 3 is 27. So 6, 8. 87. So 10 minus 87, so A30 will be minus 77. So as it goes, first term, second term, third term, and as you observe, it is going to the negative side. So the 30th number will be minus 77. Okay, let's check the next question. 11th term of an AP is minus 3, minus 11th term of in minus 3, minus half, 2, dot, dot, dot. So they are asking now, what is the 11th term? First term is this, second term is this. What is A now? A is minus 3. D is, how to check D? A2 minus A1. So minus half minus A1. A1 also is minus. So very important sign problem should not be there. A2 minus A1. So what will get? Minus half plus minus minus plus 3. So LCM, if you take 2 plus 6 upon 2, so you'll get 5 upon 2. So D is what? 5 upon 2. A is what? Minus 3. A is given, D is given. Now with the formula we can find an is equal to a plus n minus 1d. So formula is an is equal to a plus n minus 1d. What we have, a was minus 3 and 5 upon 2, minus 3, and d is 5 upon 2. A is there, d is there, and it is asked 11th term, a 11 question mark. It means n is 11. Okay, so a 11 is equal to a is minus 3 plus 11 minus 1 d 5 upon 2. So a 11 is equal to minus 3 plus 10 into 5 upon 2, 2 and the 2 5 are. So a 11 is equal to minus 3 plus 25 upon 25. So a 11 is equal to 22. So 22 is the answer of this question. Let's move with the next question, which is, in the following AP, find the missing terms in the boxes. This is an AP, it is given, it is an AP. Find the missing term. This is known as A1. First write what you know. A1 is 2, and this is second term is unknown. So A2 question mark, and you also have A3. A3 is 26. Okay, A1 is given and A3 is given. We have to find the second box. A1 is 2. A1 means first term, it is A, or you can write A. A or A1 both are same. A or A1 means same. Now A3 means what? What you mean by A3? Already we have studied in the introduction video. A3 means A plus 2D. A3 means A plus 2D. A plus 2D is 26. A plus 2D is equal to 26. Now what is A? A is the first term. A is 2. So 2 plus 2 into D is equal to 26. So 2D is 26 minus 2. So 2D is 24. So D will be what? 12. I got the D 12. Now what I want to find? I got D answer. I got A also. I have A as well as D. I want to find A2. A2 formula will be what? A2 will be A plus 1D. As A3 is A plus 2D, so A2 will be A plus 1D. So put the value. A is what? 2 plus, if you write 1 or not write, doesn't matter. So D only write. A plus D will be 14. So A2 will be 14. If still have doubts, no worries. Check the next question. It's the same type. Here it is. A is not given. A question mark. A2 is 13. Okay, A3 question mark, A3 is not given, this is A1, A2, A3 and A4 is given, A4 is 3, A2 is given and A4 is given, second term and fourth term is given. A2 means A plus D is equal to 13, A plus 1D is equal to 13. And what do you mean by A4? A4 means A plus 3D. I believe now you have understood how to write this now. A4 means A plus 3D, one less, D will be one less. A2 means A plus 1D. A plus D is 13 and A plus 3D is 3. If you know elimination method, with the help of elimination method, we have learned in pair of linear equation in two variable. We can find. So writing this in below this, A plus 3D, with the help of elimination method, we will get the answer. Minus, minus, minus. So subtract D minus 1 minus 3 minus 2D. 13 minus 3, 10. So D will be 10 upon minus 2, so D will be minus 5. D is minus 5. Substituting the value of D in any equation, I can substitute over here. If I substitute the value of D in any equation, I substitute in the easy one. So A plus D is 13. In this, I will substitute the value of D. A, D is minus, so it minus plus minus minus. D is minus 5 is 13. So A is 13 plus 5, 18. I got A and D. After getting A and D, A means first term, it means I know A is, this is what, how much? 18. I need now A3. A3 means A plus 2D. A is what? 18 plus 2 into D minus 5. So 18, 2 by the 10 minus, so it 18 minus 10 is 8. So this answer will be what? 8. Okay, A3 you got. A1 also you got. let us discuss. Still have doubts? Last question of this type. In 4th, 5th, I have given as homework. Now, this is what first term. It means A is 5. And this is what? First, second, third, fourth term. Fourth term is 9, 1 upon 2. If I can write directly or let it be. A4 is equal to 9, 1 upon 2. Okay, what do you mean by A4? A plus 3D. And 9 into the 1 upon 2 can be written as 9 to the 18. 18 plus 1, 19 upon 2. Can we substitute the value of A as 5 in this? 5 plus 3D is equal to 19 upon 2. So 3D is equal to 19 upon 2 minus 5. LCM if you take. Now solving part. So it is 3D is equal to 19 minus 5 upon 2. So D is how much? 19 minus 5, 14 upon 2. So 2 sevens are. So 7 upon 3 you are getting. Okay, if you solve, let us check if any mistake. A plus 3D, 19 upon 2. 5 plus 3D, so 19 upon 2, 3D is 19 upon 2 minus 5. So 5 to the 10, yes, here, you have done a mistake here. 2. So 10 will come here. So 3D is equal to 19 minus 10 upon 2. So 3D is 9 upon 2. So D will be what? 9 upon 6. 3 2s are 3 3s are. So 2 upon 3. D you got 2 upon 3. As you got D as 2 upon 3, I need A2 and A3. Okay, A1 is there, A2 is there, A2 and A3 is not there. A2 means A plus D. Substitute the value of A and D in this, you will get the answer. A is 5 and D is 2 upon 3. And similarly, A3 means A plus 2D. Substitute the value of A and D. We got the answer of D. What we did again, A4 was A plus 3D. Then substitute the value of A as 5 and find D. After finding D, A2 and A3 you can find, substituting the value of A and D in this. A and D substitute the value. Okay. Now next question is, which term of AP 3, 8, 13, 18 is 78? Now which term is 78? They are asking which term. Which term means they are asking N. Which number is 78? Which, when it will come 78? In simple word, when 78 will come? 3, 8, 7, 13, 18. When 78 will come? When the 78 will come? Okay, so N is asked. What is A? A will be 3. First term is 3. What is D? 8 minus 3, 5. Okay, I am doing it directly. A you know, D you know. And 78, it means AN is given. AN is 78. These three things are given. The last term is given. AN is also known as last term. I have explained you. When you will get the unknown one. So it can say the last term AN is 78. Now using the formula, AN is equal to A plus N minus 1D equal to A is what? 3. AN is 78 plus N minus 1. D is 5. If you solve it, 78 minus 3. It will be 78 minus 3 will be 75 is equal to N minus 1 into 5. Now it is a multiplication, so divide 75 upon 5 equal to N minus 1. So 5 ones are 2, 5 5s are 15 is equal to N minus 1. So N is equal to 16. So 16th term will be 78 in this AP. First term, second term, third term, fourth term. The 16th term will be 78. Simple. Let us check the next question. Now, in this, find the number of term in each of the following AP. 7, 3rd. Number of term means, again, they have asked N. How many number of term? Find the number of terms. How many terms are there? It means N is asked. What is given? A is given. A is equal to 7. Whenever AP is given, always make a habit of writing what is given. A is 7. What is D? A2 minus A1. 13 minus 7 is 6. And the last term, which is AN, is 205. What is the formula? AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 D. AN is 205. I believe you can easily solve now. Everything is given. Put the value of N and find the unknown. Okay. Check whether the minus 150 is a term of the AP 11, 8, 5 and 2. Now they are asking इज माइनस 150 विल बी टर्म ऑफ दिस ए पी 11852 एज इट गोइंग टू द नेगेटिव साइड विल माइनस 150 विल कम इन दिस ए पी दे हैव आस्क्ड चेक वेदर इट इज देयर और नॉट इट मीन्स यू हैव टू फाइंड एन एंड आफ्टर फाइंडिंग एन इफ द एन इज कमिंग एज अ नेचुरल नंबर देन यू कैन से इट इज पॉसिबल ओके लेट अस डिस्कस दिस इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन यू हैव टू चेक ए एन इज माइनस 150 ए इज वॉट 11 D is what? A2 minus A1, 8 minus 11. Remember, it is always A2 minus A1. 8 minus 11 minus 3. 8 minus 11 minus 3 will come. Okay. Now, if I solve, what is the formula again? An is equal to A plus N minus 1D. Okay. So, in this, An is minus 150. A is what? 11 plus N is not given. N minus 1, D is minus 3. Okay, if you solve this now, we will get the value of n. But if n is coming in fraction, it means it is not possible. Simply, you have to just check after solving n. I will solve this for you. 150 minus 11 is equal to n minus 1 into minus 3. So, minus 161 is equal to n minus 1 into minus 3. So, I am getting 161 upon minus 3 is equal to n minus 1. So, I am getting 161 upon 3 is equal to n minus 1. I'm getting n in fraction only because 161 upon 3 plus 1 is equal to n. And if I solve this also, 164 upon 3. After solving, I'm getting n as fraction. It is not divisible. 3 ones and 3 ones. So in this question, after this step, solve for n. If n is coming in fraction, it means it is not the term. Minus 150 is not the term of this AP. Okay? Simple. Check whether minus 150 is a term. No, it is not because n is not coming a number. It is coming in fraction. Okay. And fraction not possible, right? As it is first term, second term, third term. Is it possible we will get 4.5 term? This is first term, this is second term, this is third term, fourth term. Can I get answer? Can I possible it will be any fraction term possible? Or 2.5 term is this? Can we say like this is first term, this is half term? We say first term, then second term. We don't say this is a 2.5 term. This is third term. Then fourth term. So this will be not possible. Any fraction point sum. It should be perfect number only. Okay. Therefore, n should be a number only. Perfect natural number. So now moving to the seventh question. Find the 31st term. It means A31 is asked of an AP whose 11th term. 11th term is 38. And 16th term is 78. Very simple. 11th term is 38 and 16th term is 78. 11th term means what? A plus 10D is equal to 38. And 16th term means A plus 15D is 78. Now with the help of elimination method, A plus 15D, D will come here. A plus 10D and A plus 15D is equal to 78. Do elimination method, find A, find D with the help of elimination method. I believe you know this. So after finding A and D, you find 31st term. A31 term will be what? A plus 30D. Put the value of A and D in this. So this is simply elimination. Find A and D. After elimination, 31st term will be A plus 30D. Put the values, get the answer. Okay. Now moving to the next question, which is an AP consists of 50 terms. It means number of terms is 50. Concentrate. 50 terms are there, of which third term is 12, A3 is 12, and the last term is 106. Last term means what? If there are 50 terms, what will be the last term? It means they are talking about A50 term is 106. Again, understand, if there are 50 terms, what will be the last term? Obviously, A50 will be the last term. They have not explained, but they have given the hint. There are 50 terms. And the last term is 106. It means A50 is 106. Very important to understand this point. Now what do you mean by A3? A3 means A plus 2D is equal to 12. And A50 means A plus 49D is equal to 106. Again, with the help of this two equation elimination method, find A, find D. Okay. After finding A and D, you have to find 29th term. So A29 will be A plus 28D. I believe most of you know elimination method, just subtracting and getting A and D. Okay, after getting A and D, find and put the value of A and D in this. So you'll get 29th term also. Now let us check the next question, which is ninth question. If the third term and ninth term of an AP is 4 and minus 8, third term is 4 and ninth term is minus 8. Third term is 4, it means A plus 2D is 4 and ninth term is 8, A plus 8D is minus 8. Okay, now it's a very important question, because in this they have asked which term of this AP is 0. When you will get the AP 0? Now let us understand. Those who don't know elimination, I will discuss this in this question. Third term and ninth term of an AP is 4 and minus 8. It means a third is 4 and ninth is minus 8. So A3 is 4 and ninth is minus 8. A3 means A plus 2D is 4. 9 means A plus 8D is minus 8. Now we will do elimination, subtract. So A plus 8D is equal to minus 8. How we do elimination? Minus, minus. Here it is minus or plus. A will get 2 minus 8, minus 6D. 4 plus 8 will be 12, so D will be what? Minus 2. Minus 6, you divide to 6, minus 6, 2, 6, AD will got minus 2. Now putting the value of D in any equation, in this or this, so I'll get, so A plus 2D is equal to 4, so A plus 2 into D is minus 2 is equal to 4, so A minus 4 equal to 4, A is equal to 8. 4 will shift, there's a 4 plus 4, 8. I got A and I got D. Now what they have asked, which term of this AP is 0? It means when you will get 0 AP. So it means they have given AN will be 0. When you will get AP 0? Which term of this AP will be 0? When you will get AP 0? It means N, they have asked, when you will get the AP 0? Now what is the formula? AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 D. AN is 0. When you will get 0, they are asking which term of AP is 0. A is what? 8. N minus 1, we have to find. And D is what? Minus 2. If you solve this, minus 8 is equal to N minus 1 into minus 2. It is multiplied, so it will divide. Minus 8 upon minus 2 is equal to N minus 1. Minus minus plus, so 2 ones are 2, 4 is N minus 1. So it is 5th term. It is becoming your 5 is equal to N. It means the 5th term of AP will be 0. If I solve, the 5th term of the AP will come 0. As you check, 8, then minus 2, 6. As the first term is 8 and second term will be 6, then 4. Already also you can do, but using the formula, the 5th term will be coming 0. Okay, moving to the last question of this video, which is the 17th term of an AP exceed the 10th term by 7. Mark this question as important. 17th term exceed 10th term by 7. Exceed means plus, 10th term by 7. 17th term of an AP exceed the 10th term by 7. 17th term is more, okay, but from the 10th term by 7, so plus 7. So 17th term is exceeding by 7. So it is this way. So A17 means A plus 16D. A10 means A plus 9D plus 7. A and A will get cut. 16 minus D will come here. 16D minus 9D equal to 7. So 7D is equal to 7. So D will be what? 1. So it's a 1 mark question where you observe, find the common difference. So D is 1. Common difference is 1. I hope you have understood the video. Still you have doubts, let me know. Thank you.